Parshas Toldos, Tovshin, Pei Beis. In addition to that, tonight is Rosh Chodesh Kislev. We are just a few weeks before Hanukkah. Believe it or not, time flies. It was just Sukkot, and now we are in the month of Kislev already. Very happy month. Everyone's going to be preparing for Hanukkah. In addition to that, we are planning next week, Emirat Hashem, a celebration here for our 600th straight shiur. And that will be Emirat Hashem next Thursday night, schedule permitting. If it's not next week, it might be the week after, but we're planning, hopefully, to do it next Thursday night, special celebration here, Hakaras HaToiv, also to Biku Cholim of Lakewood, who's been hosting the shiur for the past, I don't even know how many years, probably about seven now. So we look forward to seeing everybody there. Pasuk at the beginning of this week's parsha by Yisroitzu Abanim Bekirba. Rivka Imenu was now expecting a child. She didn't know yet how many. And by Yisroitzu Abanim Bekirba, Rivka was in pain. Vatoimer im kain lomo zeo noichi. If this is the way it is, if this is the way it's going to be, what am I? Vatelech lidroish es Hashem. And Rivka went, she wanted to find out what is going on over here. And the Torah tells us that what was the answer to Rivka? The answer was that there are two different nations coming out of you. You're going to be two different nations, and it's actually two different children that you are expecting. So the Aruch Chaim HaKadosh asks a question over here. How is it that such a tzaddikus as Rivka Imenu would say, Im kein lomo zeo noichi? We understand Rivka was expecting what she thought was a child, and now she knew it was two children. But Rivka Imenu should ask, Im kein, if I'm in some pain, lomo zeo noichi? What am I? What's going on over here? Rivka should be asking. She should sort of be having like, Taina, something's wrong over here because of the pain that she's in. As Rashi told us, Rashi tells us that when, Rashi says that when she would pass by one place, so the child would try to get out, she'd pass by another place, the child would try to get out. What's going on? Rivka's, it doesn't sound right that Rivka Imenu would be complaining about this. So too, what was the answer of Shnei Goyim Vitnech, that there are two nations inside you? What does that mean? Rivka Imenu was complaining that she was in a lot of pain, that the children inside her were thrashing about and it was getting unbearable. So what does the answer of saying, you know what, Rivka, it's not one child, it's not one nation, guess what, you got two. What? How does that exactly help? She's still in pain. Does it matter if it's one nation or if it's two nations, one child, two children? Rivka Imenu had something that she wanted to take care of. This answer does not seem to be solving the problem. How did it help the situation of her pain at all? So the Nesiv HaShalom explains, and he says the following. The Torah's Avos, which is a sefer from the Slonimer dynasty, from the previous rabbis, and other Svarim HaKdoshim tell us that the word banim, the word children, that what we define as children has other meanings also. The word banim could mean things that come out of a person. Your thoughts. Banim could mean things that you produce, thoughts that come out of the person. And now, Rivka was feeling that there are two conflicting forms of machshavos battling inside her. As Rashi told us, as we said before, that when Rivka would pass a makom kodesh, she felt pain. She felt that the child wanted to get out. Yaakov Avinu was trying to get out. And Esav would do the same when they passed the Makom of Tumah. So there was Ra and Toiv Rivka didn't understand what was going on here. There was a mixture inside her of Toiv and Ra. There was good and bad. When she passed a good place, this child wanted to get out. And when she passed a place that was not so good, the child wanted to get too. So Rivka was saying, if I'm carrying a child that is so confused, I'm carrying a child that doesn't know the difference between good and bad, then lomo ze onoichi. She's asking a question, what am I producing over here? What am I doing? And you know what that question means? Says in the Siva Shalom, the entire problem of the world, when they ate from the Eitz Hadas, when the Eitz Hadas was eaten from way, way back at the beginning of time, the whole problem in the world was that good and bad, the Torah tells us that the Eitz Hadas was to tell you the difference between good and bad. And now, when they went and they ate from the Eitz Hadas, good and bad became mixed up. It wasn't clearly defined. People in the world did not know what exactly, it used to be that something was either purely good or purely bad. And now, everything was mixed up. The job of the Avos, the job of the Avos began the Olam HaTikun. That now when Avraham Avinu came along, we had a problem from the Eitz Hadas. That now good and bad was all mixed up. Came Avraham Avinu and he began the Olam HaTikun to rectify that and to clarify once again. Avraham Avinu clarified for us and he showed us the way, what is good and what is not good. So Rivka Imenu was asking, if this is what's coming from me, I have a child who's all mixed up, then what am I contributing to the growth that the Avos, that Avraham Avinu and the Yitzchak Avinu, what am I contributing to what they started? They're trying to fix up the world, to define what is good and what is bad. So that's the question of Rivka Imenu. Lama ze anoichi. I don't understand. I don't belong here. They're trying to fix the world, and I'm adding confusion. So Rivka went to find out what is going on over here. It seems that I'm very confused again with good and bad. And the answer that they gave her now makes a lot of sense. We said, what kind of an answer to her pain is Shnei Goyim Vitnech, that you have two nations inside you. Now it's very good, because her whole problem was, if I have one child that's so confused, then how am I in the family of Avraham Avinu and Yitzchak Avinu? The answer was Shnei Goyim Vitnech, that no, Rivka, the child, it's not a child that's confused. It's not one confused individual. It is two separate nations. One is totally good, and the other is really not very good at all. And that was a good answer for Rivka Imenu. See, Vishalom tells us we can also say al derech ha'avoida that shnei goyim vitnech, that you have two nations inside, it refers to the two Yetzer, refers to the Yetzer Toiv and the Yetzer Hara. The two different conflicting things that every person has inside them. Hashem, says in the Siva Shalom, set up this world in a way that we have a constant battle. Every person has a constant battle and a struggle. And the goal in everyone's life is, like it says in our parsha, V'rav Yavoid Tzair. V'rav is the Yetzer Hara. The Yetzer Hara comes first. As soon as a person's born, he has the Yetzer Hara. Tzair is the Yetzer Toiv. The Yetzer Toiv arrives when a person becomes a gadol. When a person becomes 13 years old, when a boy or a man becomes 13 years old, that's when the Yetzer Toiv first arrives. So the pasuk tells us, V'rav Yavoid Tzair, that the goal and the job of every person is that the younger one, the Yetzer Toiv, should be ruling over the Yetzer Hara. Reb Chaim Vital says on the Mishnah in Masechta Pesachim, the Mishnah says, Orli Arba'a Asar Bait Knesset HaChametz. On the eve of the 14th, we are Baitik for Chametz. Says Rav Chaim Vital, a pshat, a thought on this Mishnah. What does it mean? Orl Arba'a Asar Bait Knesset HaChametz. At the outset of your 14th year, when a person is 13 years old, at the outset of your 14th year, and now you have a Yetzer Tov, so then, Boit Kenes HaChametz, we begin to the real work of our lives to search out the Yetzer Hara in order to defeat him. For the first years of a person's life, you only have a Yetzer Hara, you don't have a Yetzer Tov to send to battle. Or La Basar, now when it comes before your 14th year, when you're 13, or when a woman is 12, now you have a Yetzer Tov, that's when you have to go out and go out to this battle. And the idea is that at the end, V'rav Yavoytzo'ir, that the one who is there for the longer time, the Yetzera, should become and be subservient to the Yetzera Tov, to push the Yetzera under the Yetzera Tov. And really, this is the story of the entire life of every Jew. This is the story of every person. The struggle of a Yisroitzatu Abonim Bekirba. Abonim, we said, refers also to a person's thoughts, to a person's machshavos, to the way you're going to lead your life. And every person has that by Yisroitzatu Abonim Bekirba, that even after decades of our lives, and not just when we're young, when we get a bit older too, we're still in that battle. And sometimes a person, as Tzvi Shalom says, sometimes a person can really get down. Year after year, we face the same battles. You have a Yetzer Hara, and you try to set your Yetzer Tov on the Yetzer Hara. Either it works, or it doesn't work. It works a little better. It doesn't work so much. But we need to remember that what HaKadosh Baruch Hu really wants from us is that we continue the battle. A person doesn't come to the realization of finality in my life that I have totally won over the Yetzer Hara. It doesn't work that way. The life of a person, the way HaKadosh Baruch Hu set it up, is that Vayisroitzatu Abonim Bekirba and V'rav Yavoytzo'ir is the goal. And that battle really never stops. And we need to always have V'yodoy Oichezes Ba'akev Esav. That even though sometimes the Esav, even though the Yetzer Hara will sometimes be strong and he will win many times, but what Hashem wants to see is V'yodoy Oichezes Ba'akev Esav, that you're always grabbing onto his ankle. I'm not going to let you go. I'm not going to let you, Yetzer Hara, pull me down. And I'm not going to let you feel victory that you make me get down where I feel like I can't battle anymore. And really, we need to understand that no one is perfect. There isn't a person in this world who is perfect. And the battle never ends. And that's the lesson, really, in this week's Parsha, that we need to focus, have our mind on what's good. We need to understand what the goal is. We need to understand what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants is to keep our eye on the prize and keep your eye on the battle. Just understand that if you lose today and you're not so perfect today, what the Yetzer Hara wants most in this world is that you should be down, that you should give up. Because once you give up, and once you're down, and once you're depressed, and once you feel that you can't anymore, then the Yetzer Hara has you put away. Anything will go, it can get you to do anything. And that is what we have to learn from this week's Parsha. The battle of Yaakov and Esav, the Yaakov's entire life, Yodoy Oichezes Ba'akev Esav. Esav, you may win today, but you're not going to pull me down. You're not going to pull me down. You're not going to win the battle forever, because tomorrow I'm going to get up and I'm going to battle again. And every one of us has to know that. The battle's never over. Hashem wants to see you take on the fight. He wants to see you say, if I didn't do it today, I could win tomorrow. That's the lesson from Rivka, the lesson of Yaakov and Esau.